Hi guys, I usually animate just to tell stories. Well, at least I try to. But today, I wanted to make something informative. Recently, I came across a poster made by Project Democracy, and it read, "Simple steps to identify fake news." So it got me thinking. I asked my friend who'd shown me the poster if I could make a video based around this idea. He said yes, and here we are. Fake news. What is fake news? Well, fake news is a form of news consisting of deliberate misinformation or hoaxes spread via traditional or online media. It is written and published usually with the intent to mislead people from the actual truth. In India, we have more than 560 million internet users, and today in 2020, it's no longer like the old times when only a few had access to internet services. We are the second largest online market. Now, I don't want to get into the maths of it. Just know we have a lot of people using the internet. And right now, because of the lockdown, almost everyone has a phone in their hand all day. For the people who make this fake news, it's like a Christmas for them, because there are a lot of vulnerable minds and internet users for them to exploit and mislead. Even our elders often fall prey to this time and again, as forwarding messages in WhatsApp is so easy and so common. Recently, even I almost fell prey to such misleading piece of information. I received a picture through WhatsApp where it said that the internet would be shut down for the next 10 days. At first, I freaked out. Internet shut down? How will we survive? So the first thing I did is I went to the trending section of YouTube, but there was nothing there. Then I proceeded to type the following keywords: Modi's speech, internet shut down today, and still nothing. I quickly told my brother and my friend, and after about 15 minutes of research, all three of us came to the conclusion that this news was fake. Okay, so I come back to the poster made by Project Democracy. Here are some simple steps to identify fake news. Number one is, look at the news source. Can you identify the publisher of the news? Which website is it coming from? What is the news outlet? The vlog that published the news, is it a legit one? Here are some news sources that you can trust. News that comes from WHO, World Health Organization, from the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, from BBC, from CNN, etc. News sources not to trust so easily are news channels which don't look legit, or in other words, news channels which are fake looking. Only trust those news channels which can be traced with a legit website and a source. It is very easy to make logos nowadays, so watch out for the channels that could be fake. They look and sound like regular news channels with just a slight alteration in the name and the logo. And another news source not to be trusted at all is news that you get from WhatsApp, Facebook, and other social medias. Second thing what we can do is we can look for visual clues. A lot of the fake news use Photoshop images to portray them as being real. One example is when Kiran Bedi tweeted a picture with monuments like the Big Ben, Leaning Tower of Pisa, Twin Towers, Statue of Liberty, all lit up in tricolors, and she wrote, "Fantastic Jai Hind." But after some fact-checking, we came to know that all these photos were photoshopped. The third point is, beware of sensational news. Fake news often use religion and political symbols to exploit our existing bias and to gain extra credibility. Last but not the least, go for a second opinion. Everyone has a phone in their hand, so any news that you come across, especially through social media, just Google it. It's like taking a second opinion from a doctor. We should try and find at least two or three authentic news sources from Google. This lockdown can be a difficult time for some of us. I know we're just supposed to sit at home, and with all the misinformation and memes going around, it is easy to be taken in by the trend of panic and boredom. But let's take this time to be a little bit more positive, a bit more motivated, and a lot more productive in every way that we can. Help others understand what fake news is. Help your friends, relatives, and most of all your parents. Differentiate between what's real and what's not. The best way to tackle fake news and not let it spread is to make each other aware. So don't let fake news harm anyone. Don't let it spread fear and panic. We do not need this right now. So lastly, I'd like to say no to fake news. Thank you so much.